I love Pokemon. As you can clearly see, I enjoy the games, I used to like the show, and I have an extensive collection. With that being said, my name is Armando Romero, and this is the Armando Romero Show. And recent Pokemon news, Pokemon Black and White 2 has been announced for Japan and the Americas. Now, so far the news is that it's going to release in June in Japan, but no word on when it will be released here in America. This is really interesting news because, according to sources and whatnots, Pokemon Black and White 2 will be, it's a direct sequel to Pokemon Black and White, which is totally out of the left field because no one was expecting that. Everybody was expecting Pokemon Gray. But no, Game Freak decided, we'll give you a sequel. This is the first time ever that this has actually been done. That two different versions of a sequel come out. Usually it's just one version, like Emerald or something like that. But no, not this time. Why? Still unknown as to how this is going to continue the story, because as far as we know, it is going to continue the story of Black and White, right? But how? Are we going to play as a new character, starting all over, or are we gonna be the same characters we were in Black and White? Very, very curious, because if we do start as a new character, is it gonna be in the same region? Is it gonna be in a new region, or? So far, information is very scarce and hardly anyone knows anything. Oh, by the way, if you wanna watch the announcement trailers, they're over here. Right here, right on the left. You can click on them. I can't show you in this video because this video is monetized. But anyways, if we do start as a new character, are the old characters of the original Black and White going to show up as cameos? Or are we going to just take the shoes again where Black and White left off? Which I doubt it. I don't know if that would make much sense. But it wouldn't really make sense either if it was a new region. Or would it? Who knows? Speculation is up. If you have an idea, tell me in the comment sections below. But I've been reading a lot of forums of what people expect or want in a new Pokemon game. And I have to disagree. There's some that I disagree. I don't want it to turn into a giant MMO. Come on, that's not Pokemon. I don't want that. I mean, sure, I like the idea of, completing one region and heading out to another like the show was. This was done in Gold, Silver, and those related games. But Soul Silver? I mean, Gold, Silver, and Crystal. Jesus. Right? It's done that, where you could go Johto and Kanto. But that was story related. But in terms of going to a new region and all that, I don't see that as possible. Not really, because then, if you, especially with DLC, because I also read a lot of people was talking about DLC, right? So I was thinking, maybe what if they were talking about, getting a new region as DLC? Because Pokemon is a valid candidate for Nintendo downloadable content. But I don't think that adding a new region would work. No. I just don't think so. I mean, then what's the point of releasing games, right? I mean, after you release one game, you can just download blah blah blah. But anyways, back to the main topic of Black and White 2. On the cover of the game, over the announcement, if you see in the announcement trailer, is a combination of the mascots of Black and White. I'm terrible with names, but I know them. It's like a combination, like they fuse together. I don't think so. I think this is just a different form of that gray Pokemon, which I think is called something. I don't know. I'm old. I like Pokemon, but I just can't remember the new legendary nicknames. But this is very interesting as to, because this marks, I think, a new road for the Pokemon franchise. I think it's going to go in places that we may or may not like. But anyways, that's all information about Black and White is that. And the thing about what I was talking about DLC is because Nintendo I think they said last year that they're willing to do downloadable content. They're offering that option to developers, but it's up to the developers to see if they want, you know, be paid DLC or free DLC. Me, I much rather have free, but whatever. The two games that I read that are very high up that may or big candidates is what I'm trying to say for DLC is Super Mario 3D Land and Pokemon. Yeah. But Pokemon Black and White 2 is not releasing for the Nintendo 3DS. But it is releasing for the DS, but not for the 3DS. Not yet. I think for the next generation, maybe. I don't know. So a lot of people were discouraged by the fact that it's not going to be on the 3DS. But fear not, you can play the DS game on 3DS. It shouldn't be a problem. But I'm really hoping to see a new Pokemon game on the 3DS. I think the 3DS can handle even better game, even better 3D stuff, better 3D models. I don't know. I really like the battle system that they implemented in Black and White. It was a huge step. Maybe redefine the pixels and maybe make it look better. I don't know. At this point, I'm just rambling. So my name is Armando Romero, and you have been watching me ramble for who knows how long, and I'll see you next time. Oh, by the way, review of the Nintendo 3DS is coming soon. The second part is pretty soon. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey! I knew that was gonna happen.
Come on.